Here at the Goose and Jim and Van Nuys talking to boxing trainer Ricky Funes. Today we're going to talk about bob and weave.
This is where you start at first.
Okay, what is this for, first of all?
Mostly it's just to have head movement, waist movement, and self-defense actually also.
Okay.
Make sure you're keeping your hands up all the time.
So you move while you bob and weave.
Yeah, well,
you don't stand in one place.
You keep your hands tight. You have different sets of drills. First, we use this. We use 3 rounds. Me and my nephew or other fighters that I have their hands up tight. Make sure they're bobbing and weaving with their hands up tight, going under. Then we have another 3 rounds to throw punches.
And this also helps the hand-eye coordination, punch coming at you?
Yeah, because you're throwing punches.
And you don't pay attention 1 second, you get hit.
Exactly, throwing punches and you bring your hands right back up. So you're throwing punches, boom, 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 go under, boom, touch the body.
Low blow. But that's very important in boxing.
Of course.
One thing I've noticed with a lot of pros, they don't keep their hands up after the first, second round. The hand like slides like to the chest. They don't keep it.
That's one of the main things that I was taught here. Making sure your hands a really tight and nice defense. People say, you want to teach me how to fight with my hands? Normally fighters, they come and do this.
Carl Froch, Sergio Martinez, Roy Jones Jr.
Edison Miranda started like that.
Yeah.
But normally we start off doing this because once you start going into 1 round, 2 rounds, your arms...
You get tired.
You get tired.
And if you get hit on the arms...
Not only that, you start opening your hands wide open. So you keep everything short and tight.
Who do you think today, besides Mayweather, has the best defense in boxing? Who doesn't get hit a lot?
Man, there's a lot of fighters that get really hit. There's nobody, you can't compare nobody to Mayweather. I'm trying to find out right now who. Let me see. I can't give you no name.
You can't give me no name. I'm going to ask the viewing public if they can help you out with this.
Who? Yeah, can you guys help me out, please?
Who has the best defense in boxing?
You know, since I've been reading some of your comments earlier and some of the videos, there's a lot of...
Guillermo...
There's a lot of boxing experts out there, you know?
So, everybody's an expert. How about Guillermo Rigondeaux?
Well, you know what? You proved me wrong on that video. He is a bad boy. Has a great defense. He's vicious.
400 amateur fights, you know, I mean, and he won like 385.
The only reason why I doubted Rigondeaux a lot was because when he fought, when we fought actually in Texas, in Houston, he was not that impressive that night to me. But you know what, when he fought Donaire, he stepped it up big time. But other than that, Eli, I don't know. You got a lot of boxing experts out there that trash talk you, thinking they know boxing. They're you know, come on.
How about you?
You know what, I like that they talk too much crap, but I'm from the street, so I keep it real. None of them will step up into the ring and do what we do. They could talk, Ricky sucks, or this fighter sucks, or Ellie sucks, but you know what, they're at home sitting, that's all they do, eating probably bonbons. Like Peggy from Mary Children did.
There you have it, Ricky Funes. Stay tuned for EsNews.com. I'm Eli Sekpak reporting.
Ricky.